We're starting with a pre-tape where it's going to be a seamless transition from tape to live. Pepsi has been very collaborative. They're very creative over there. And they are an essential piece of the Super Bowl halftime family.
And play that.
The show starts with this very fantastical built set that appears kind of like a two-dimensional flat photograph. As the camera starts moving, you're starting to realize how this has been built, the three-dimensionality of it.
I think one of the biggest tragedies is people not realizing what gets put into making something, how hard a simple shot or thing might be in reality for everyone on set.
Oh, this is gonna be green screen too, or just this?
This is the bottom of the Jumbotron. This is all in the Jumbotron.
It's gonna start going up.
Yeah, we pull out of the Jumbotron screen, floating. We pull past the floating choir guy.
Got it.
We see you sitting on the Jumbotron, choir guy.
That's the pre-show.
That's all pre-recorded.
What's happening here is we are suspending a choir member. What the piece of continuity is going to be is both audio and visually, him descending into frame and then seeing the same person at the Super Bowl descending into our frame as we cut to our final choir, and it works like a magic trick, and everyone's like, ta-da. Wow, that felt seamless and it felt live.
There you go.
But if it goes badly, it's because it looks fake.
Hey.
Hi.
Hey, so I'm here with Lamar.
Yeah.
I'm apologizing on Abel's behalf for the last minute switch. Musically, he feels it enhances the sonic progression of the show. I don't think there's anything we can do to talk him out of it.
We'll figure it out.
When The Weeknd was looking for a choreographer and then Charm's name came up, we knew that Charm would be great. We've done the Grammys together. We've done BET Awards together. All of her performances are the ones that everybody talks about.
I was home and I got a phone call. And I think it was Lamar. He was like, hey, so what's your process like? Because we're doing the Super Bowl. And literally, I was like, I don't know if Lamar could tell on the phone. I was like, Super Bowl. I had to keep my cool, you know? I'm from Compton, California. As a kid, I loved to choreograph. I loved to make moves. I didn't know it was called choreography at the time. My mentor, Fatima Robinson, we met when I was 10 years old. And then I was her assistant when she did her Super Bowl. Now I'm choreographing this amazing performance for this amazing artist. And in COVID, it's crazy. I met Abel in our first rehearsal. I've seen his videos, of course. I've seen his performances. And I kind of just based the choreo off of what I thought he would do. And then when he got into the room, he saw it. Then we collabed. And it built and it makes sense. Everything is like an extension of him because he's very in there. I love artists who are hands-on with the creative process and knowing what he wants to feel around him. And to see him throw himself in the middle of the dancers and just go for it is fucking dope, man. This particular performance, there's different sections around Abel. There's 20 dancers from LA. We have the choir, which is like 75 guys who are from all over, locals, as the choir, and then we have our field. So you see the three pods. With COVID, we can't have too many rehearsals. Some people rehearse for 3-4 months for Super Bowl. I think I've had 2 rehearsals. And 1 rehearsal was on a 4-hour Zoom. I know this is crazy. We're gonna get it done, though. We're gonna get it done. We're gonna get it done.
Normally, dancers are in the room
and I create. But the cast has never done it full from the top to the bottom. And we kind of got to use our imaginations to go, okay, this could work.
Different song if you scoop. Here we go.
You got it. Here, let's place it, everybody. Ready? Abel kind of wanted this sound carried through kind of the whole thing.
Are we going to be doing the pads and then the hook, or you want to do the hook first and the pads second, or vice versa? Or?
Totally up to you guys.
I'm going to suggest that the first part of this is only the baritone, pretty much. Is that correct?
It is the berry basses. Here we go.
Working people I know, and he's put his heart and soul into this. Whenever he's seen in front of the camera, he wants it to be about his music. He doesn't want it to be anything else other than his craft.
One, two, three, and. That's a good balance. Two, three.
Touch me, feel me.
Very cool.
One thing about Abel is he hasn't changed a bit. He's still that same dude I met 14 plus years ago. I met Abel first day of high school. I remember he had like a baby blue do-rag on, and I had a Killer Cam sort of pink polo shirt. We were just admirers of art, cinema, fashion, the underground rap scene at the time. That really sparked our friendship. He started exploring songwriting and doing music. I was gonna become a registered nurse until I met Abel Tesfaye and he dragged me on his adventure. Abel and myself both had single mothers that were providing for everyone in the household. So when we moved out of our home, we got even poorer, you know? We've been on such a journey. I shot the House of Balloons cover in my mom's bathtub 10 years ago. And to go from that image to rolling out the Super Bowl performance in that 10-year span, it's beyond words.
Mr. Collins!
Play, girl.
What up, baby?
So,
should I be afraid?
Of course you should be afraid. No, this is just a check-in. The choir all have the N95s, right?
Yes, sir.
All right, so I talked to Seth. They're fine with the bandages for the field cast. They're not fine. Oh, we just lost you. Lila Nicole's never done this show before, but she's done a ton of fashion shows. We've done a ton of award shows together. She knows how to apply the things that she's learned over the years into this moment.
Last year, I wanted to go to the Super Bowl, but the ticket prices were astronomical. Jesse knows everybody, so I was like, yo, Jess, help me get some tickets. He calls me a couple months later. You want to do the Super Bowl? So I thought he wanted to go to the Super Bowl. He's like, all right, so you're gonna have to be available from October till whenever. And I was like, wait, like, what do you mean? Like, it didn't make sense for a minute. So I acted like it wasn't a big deal. I get off the phone, and I was just sitting right here. And I was just sitting there like,
did I just get the Super Bowl? Like, it didn't really kick in.
I put on the Beyonce halftime show, and it, like, snapped. I just started crying.
I'm not an emotional crying kind of person, but I'm a diehard football fan. It's me and my father's thing. Ever since I was a little girl, every Sunday we would watch football. So this job is just very special to me because of my dad. If you see me skipping around, like, you know, it's just what it is. I'm laughing because if you look over there, look what he's wearing. It's my team. They're creative children.
Okay, so our show is an extension of his chaos. So the only way for you to understand that is to see one of his videos. Yeah. I saw you dancing in a crowded room. You look so happy when I'm not with you. So you'll see the red jacket, mm-hmm. Black gloves, black tie, black suit, black pants, black shoes. That's our wardrobe, but ours is just a multiplied version. Mm-hmm. Gloves, tie, belt. So we're basically gonna mimic this look. So here is our final version. Everybody will be wearing this red jacket. We have to make hundreds of these in a very small amount of time.
Dear red jacket, how I love and hate you. I'm just kidding.
His shoes are custom made, and we cannot get them. So here is a dancer version for everybody. It's just a basic black dance shoe.
Wait, this stuff, whatever. Hold on. What are you doing?
You like the front?
These are not even the shoes that I ordered. Oh, shit.
Oh. Boy, they look fly.
Yeah, but they can't look like they're supposed to look like a basic black shoe. See, they sent me the wrong shit. Look.
China?
Oh. No, look. That's what I ordered. Hold.
Uh-oh.
They're all wrong?
All the same?
Yeah, they're all wrong. Same thing.
All? We don't have to pull all of them. And how many of those are? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
This is wrong.
Now we have to return them all and try and find 30 more pairs to match. And we need it in 3 days for our fittings and for our setups.
Listen, I was probably the most talented bench rider at Jeb Stuart High School.
Hey, look at you now, at the Super Bowl.
Yes. I'm gonna talk to Hamish.
I'm glad you caught that. Oh, ah!
See? Because you said that.
His five-year-old is showing. It's surreal that we're actually here. It is one of the biggest stages. There's that pressure of having to create 14 minutes of perfection in front of 120 million people. So that's just the general stress underlying everything. This is probably the biggest thing that I've done and the thing my mom is most proud of. Like, she's trying to get all the scoop. You know, I'm like, I can't tell you, Mom. You'll put it on Facebook, hashtag producer mom. And she puts that with all of her posts.
You need your helmet to go on the stage.
I got my hat.
I don't know how to work this.
I'm confused by this.
So this is the front.
Wait, what?
Aaron, what, how does this
how
work?
Does this work?
What is this? Why?
I think these are all backwards.
Thank you.
I didn't know assembly was required. What's going on?
How are these people going to produce the Super Bowl when they can't even produce the hat? As producers, we're working hand in hand with The Weeknd and his team on all creative elements. We're almost like the glue, bringing all of the pieces together.
Ready?
Jess, please don't kill us.
Dun, 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 dun. I want a golf cart on every show now.
Oh, God, here we go.
Here we go. This is the fun
part. Oh, no! Please,
don't. Where do we get the...
Ah! Sorry.
It's the park for me. Oh, I thought you had it, Jesse. I thought you had it.
I thought I had it, too. I tried.
pretty badass.
Wow.
Wow, this feels like a real state, right?
Wow.
This is still a work in progress, but I know it's gonna be great.
To have everybody come together in this stadium to see the set, to have it all come together is really gratifying.
When you guys are done, save the packaging, okay? Most of the stuff is already on hangers, so when we're hanging them, we're gonna design it like a store. Basically, they would walk through, make it really super easy. Okay. And we're probably gonna dress about 400 people. Yeah. I got everybody some really cool jackets that say wardrobe team on the back, so they can distinguish who we are. We just gotta be our best. We have to make sure that we have fun while we're doing it, and that the Weeknd is in love with it as much as we are. Cool? All right.
Okay, here we go. Lean to the right in 5, 6, 7, 8, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7,
position. Position one. Let's see how many eight counts it takes you to get to these positions, okay?
Aye, aye, aye. The motivation behind it, yeah? You're an extension of Abel, extension of the Weeknd. He's not doing back handsprings out here. He's vibing. So everyone needs to vibe. Dun, dun, na, 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 dun, dun. It's a vibe, yeah? It's not y'all. Let's try again. 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, aha, get that rhythm. Down, boom, 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 boom. Cool? Yeah.
So that's the march out, right? Are they going out to the 50?
When they start this, it's
he's with them.
With them.
And he's not doing that, right?
No, he's just going, this is it.
He's just kind of doing his fall around.
Yeah. Let's go!
I've never done anything on this magnitude with volunteers. And we're leaning on them a lot because they are the field.
Okay, everybody, the upper eight, they're good. You're gonna face midfield to the 50.
It's beyond choreography at this point. I lean on KP to help facilitate everything because it's a lot. So KP and I are like.
Well, can they be walking during that part or not?
Oh, no, they can be walking. Oh.
My name's Kristen Patterson Terry. They call me KP. This is my 23rd halftime show. I was part of Super Bowl 26 as part of the choreography and the field direction team. That really got me super excited. And it just kind of snowballed from there. I'm responsible for the cast on the field. Charm and I work to make sure that all the parts integrate together.
Blue stickers, go to your blinding lights position. Unless you have a white sticker, then don't move because you have a new spot. No one should be standing on the hash marks.
They may not be pro dancers. They might not even think they can dance. But when they come into rehearsal, we'll teach them what they don't know. The bottom line is, do they want to create and be a part of something that's seen by the world at halftime of the Super Bowl?
Honestly, this spacing super helped just see what it's going to look like and how we can spread out to make the look that they want to get later. I see like maybe 5, 6 guys that just, it's way over their head.
If we teach everyone the other choreography, we'll know for sure.
So we're saying we have a chance.
Every year presents itself with a new set of circumstances. once it sinks in that it's COVID and they have to go to mandatory testing and wear PPE, it's just harder to find the groups of people that are willing to go through all the extra steps that COVID layers on to participation. That's going to be our biggest challenge.
5, 6, 7, 8.
I'm late.
Yeah. 5, 6, 7, 8.
What you doing?
I'm sorry.
Come on.
Yeah, that basketball.
Am I ready?
The Super Bowl is a once-in-a-lifetime experience.
We're from Nigeria.
Yeah.
Born there, raised here.
Yeah. Let's represent. I forgot how this song.
Oh, yeah.
Dancing with my twin brother is like something not a lot of relatives get to experience.
You know, twins have like that type of
telepathy.
Yeah, twin telepathy. Like if he gets hurt, you know, I can feel it.
Our family is real proud of us. I'm pretty sure they would like never even imagine us being on TV. I ran track ever since middle school. In high school, I got like very competitive in it.
Who's
that
is who?
I like the top bunk.
He already claimed the top bunk. The reason why he claimed the top bunk because I should be overweight. So he said he don't want me to
fall.
And squish him. So
these are going to be kept.
Yeah, it's going to be kept for a long while.
127, that's me.
I'm 142. Tell Charm that 142 is looking for her.
Because
I want to take her out to Waffle House, you know? So.
So one day they came back home. They said, Mommy, what happened if they choose to be participate in the Super Bowl? How would you like that? I said, wow, I would be the happiest woman on earth.
Hurry up, hurry up, hurry up. Oh, yeah, hold on. Hurry up!
They said, Mommy, they're not going to work for 2 weeks. They said, really? Are they going to pay you guys? They said, no. They said, yes, Mommy, don't worry. It's an opportunity. Never know what will come up, you know? I said, well, it's okay. I am impressed.
Hey, hold on. There you go.
Damn, party. There you go.
Come on, man, shut up, bro. That's when it come down. And then when it come down, this will come down, right? So I do touch.
Oh, man.
And then hold it.
Go ahead and run 2-3, going up to 30. Set? Yeah, I love that.
We've been worried about this fly gag from the beginning, where we could fly them, the winds. You do have fans in the building. You don't want people jumping on the wire and flying down like they're Captain Jack. There's a lot of challenges. It's like one of those things where if we couldn't get that right, we would probably have to change the whole open.
What we're learning here is that in rehearsal, if we need to adjust timing here and there, then it's about a 5-minute adjustment.
Our production designer, Bruce Rogers, he's been doing this show for many years. He's seen it all. So I know this is gonna go off great.
The highest that our person can be, right, is that X brace.
Okay.
This is my 15th Super Bowl. My first one was with Prince. The last time we were in Tampa, we were with Bruce Springsteen here, so it brings back a lot of memories. I grew up in Odessa, Texas, where Friday Night Lights was written. All my life, football was king. To be able to be the halftime show designer for this many years means a lot, not only to me, but my family and friends back home in Texas.
Bruce, I don't know if you want to speak to what exactly Lou Media is planning on doing around that area.
Because of COVID, there were already rules that were told to us by the NFL. Some of the restrictions included not being out on the field. Every other halftime show takes an army. You're building the set in front of the live audience. And they were like, you got to do a halftime show that doesn't do that. The Weeknd's creative team had the Vegas look that they were playing in. Ez drew this beautiful rendering of this choir setup. She's a wonderful opera designer.
I had always thought that we could start to, you know, reveal the lights in a quite abstracted way, just the window lights, so we get some energy. I think it's really just the abstraction of the lights in the windows.
The concept was to take us out of a Super Bowl world and put us in an Able world. So we pivoted to build a different kind of halftime show, one that doesn't get loaded in 7 minutes, but gets loaded in 3 weeks, like a massive outdoor opera. We're on the north concourse of the stadium. So this gives you a pretty good sense of scale of what we're trying to do. That's an LED screen. We'll feed in content that almost looks like an infinite run of the different tiers of scenery. It'll change with the mood of the song and create just that final layer of surfacing. That set piece alone weighs 100,000 pounds. It'll be populated with about 75 choir members. Your minds are gonna be blown, but the set splits right here, right down the middle. So it's designed to move smoothly and quickly. Underneath that is the infinity room. So this is 50% complete right now, but when it's all said and done, there's probably about 7,000 light bulbs that'll be active with sign work and all that sort of thing. This infinity room is gonna be super cool because people in TV land are gonna be like, wait, where did we go? There's so much at stake to pull off as perfect of a show as possible. That's the biggest challenge.
What's your waist?
32.
32?
Take a look at the 40. Shall we do it this one?
So you excited about Super Bowl?
Oh, most definitely. It's a once-in-a-lifetime chance.
Oh, yeah. You guys going to be out there on the field?
Exactly.
It's going to be good times.
Now I'm going to tell my kids about this. You don't even know.
All right. So I'm going to go ahead and give you these.
Yes, sir.
The opening's here, so hang your clothes over on that side.
You're good. So you're done. You feel comfortable in this?
Yes,
you want to see a little choreo just for fun?
No.
Let's
choreo.
See what you got. Hey. Chris, what nationality are you?
I'm Puerto Rican.
I'm Puerto Rican.
Are you really?
Hey. Today, we have all of our dancers. We're fitting them super quick, making sure that they are tailored and precise and getting them out for rehearsals. I'm going to pin it in the back for you.
Okay.
It's really, really challenging to do what we do. To do it quickly, efficiently, and safely. JC!
Hey, what you got here?
I think I got something special in these boxes.
Ah! Check this out!
Made it?
The right shoes!
Yes, yeah, the right shoes!
The shoes. They were delivered, and we can move on to something more exciting.
Jaji! Okay, so we have another snafu. The Weeknd wants to add black jackets into the look now, so we need to get 130 jackets by tomorrow. He just wants this blingy, you know, classic tuxedo look.
Right.
We can do it. It's gonna be a lot easier to
find them opposed to making them, because making them is gonna take a while.
I mean, I have a uniform place that can get us the black jackets tomorrow. Or we can source as many as we can,
and then
and let's
rest.
Say we only have 20 left or something like that.
That works, yeah.
It could be different vendors. They could be really similar.
They don't have to be the same.
But what he's looking for is kind of like a solid here and a sequence in the front in black.
The jacket that we're going to get is going to be plain black. So all you got to do is come, spray the adhesive on there, boom. When it dries,
sew it on. Yeah. All right, got it.
So it's like an embroidery blazer with like satin look on.
To better assist you, please select from one of the following system options. Habla español o prima nueve.
What time do you close today? If there's some way that we could get, like, a wholesale rate. Hi, how are you?
Good, how can we help you today?
I need 120 jackets sent overnight, if possible. Can I give you the SKU number to see if you have it in stock? We were thinking of, like, 50 medium, 50 large, and 20 extra large. How do we get a wholesale price if you guys already have it marked at 135? That's real multitasking. Did you see that?
So they start in the robes, and then they all
they
go to
start in the robes. They have the black jacket underneath. They have to take the black jacket off and then end up in the red jacket. So they have three changes now.
Oh.
That's kind of where we are.
The place that sold you the first 14 can't make it happen?
Nope. Impossible.
How's it impossible?
They don't have, like, a closet full of sequins. People don't wear those things like that. I mean, we're just going to see what we can find and try and make it work. You know?
May the force be with you. You can make it happen.
Oh, and KP asked me to help with the casting.
You're talking about volunteers.
Volunteers? They don't even have close to the numbers they need.
All right, let's hit KP and see where she's at with it.
Our goal was to do 300 plus Abels for a grand finale, like an army of him. But with COVID, we've lost people. They're just not showing up. And then some people dropped out because they actually want to see the game. How's it going?
Good to see you. Great. How are you?
Good. Nice to meet you.
Good.
So casting, Lila thinks we're in trouble.
As quick as we get people in, people would drop out.
Okay.
Because it all was like in the same time zone of, oh, well, wait a minute, I don't get to watch the game if I'm in the halftime show.
Got it.
So you don't see any of the game. The hard sell.
Yeah.
And then we had a couple people come through testing and test positive. So they're out too. So we're going to have this as a cycle now till the end.
So if somebody test positive,
they're just out.
They're just out? Okay.
I like that. I'm good with that.
Yeah. All right. We'll just keep on keeping on.
String players are now at the top, but the top is 12 and we only need 11. So this guy will leave.
The back row is the choir.
Well, these two are the COVID replacements. I don't have their photos. They're the last backups that just came in.
People we can't move are the violins.
Right.
We can't move the choir boy. All the dancers just got in. They've never been together. And before everyone gets on the flight, everyone has to take a test. Two of my guys tested positive, so they couldn't get on their flight. So then we had to replace with... So now this is another structure change that we're doing. And these people don't know the choreography at all.
Yay.
Guys, it's starting to hit me that it's a lot of shit that needs to get done. Let me see if I have this, a violin rehearsal.
They're dancers. So it's like trying to teach dancers not to look like dancers and to actually look like musicians. That was...
We brought two instructors in to help the guys properly play. We're doing what we gotta do. You know, we're doing what we have to do. Here they go. We have to have rehearsal with the choir. I have to have rehearsal with my Infinity Room crew. I have to have rehearsal in general. We're gonna get it done. Damn it! Damn it! One, two, three. So let's put your violin there.
go.
Oh, that's so great to be here.
There's anxiety about our first walkthrough with Lamar and Alex and the whole creative team. Yes, they've seen iPhone video, they've seen renderings, drawings, but what is their reaction when they walk on the stage? Because they're basically Abel's eyes.
We're basically 50 feet above the
ground
planet
floor,
Earth.
Man.
This is definitely gonna feel like rock star moment.
Yeah.
In the building, I mean, in the stadium, but on TV as well.
It's crazy. I'm just astounded by the scale. It's way more massive than I imagined. Feels really, really good.
Lamar's here and he likes the set. So there you go.
Is Abel landing tonight at 10:30 or is it earlier?
Hey, Bruce, what's the best way into the Infinity Room?
When the Weeknd walks in here, I need him to feel comfortable that this is what we've been talking about and working on for so many months.
What up, bro?
Come on, Abel, we'll check it out.
That's the break. That's the center line of the set. So this whole thing goes and that goes.
So we did talk about there's like a step. I think it's between the T and the Empire State Building on Earned It. Maybe you do it there. During that string section, it's enough time for you to sneak down.
So basically, you would have to walk three times. And it just gives us three different positions and three different good angles and backgrounds.
I don't want to be, like, singing, like, while I'm moving.
Right.
Especially on a song like that, like, I feel like I'm covered for most of it anyway.
Yeah, I get it.
Yeah, like, I think you try it Monday, and if it feels weird, then we'll just pick a stationary spot.
Can I see Save Your Tears, like, from here?
Mm-hmm.
Can I see the movement?
Okay.
The rest of it feels good though, right?
Yeah.
Charm, go back up to the very top. Yeah, and look at that position that we were saying. Since September, it's been a kind of a clinical scientific way of getting this done. And now it's like you feel the chemistry, you hear the music. Everybody's spitballing ideas, and this is when it goes from good to great. So you could do it right there. Okay.
How long was your day today?
I woke up at 7, and so I've been going ever since.
Wow, that's a strong 12 hours.
I know. At my age, you know, usually I would have had, you know, dinner with Jell-O at 4.
I got nothing.
The executive producer tends to be the one kind of responsible for everything. To me, it's like not being afraid. You have to be that person that's willing to dig into the weeds. My leadership philosophy is something I've developed over time. I think the core of it is I'm willing to work as hard or harder than anybody else. Sometimes it's motivation. Sometimes it's pushing people. You know, every day there's always a different problem. I think just be able to think quickly and always remain calm.
I got photographed in memory. I have high functioning autism. I can remember all the moves from rehearsal without looking at the video. This is the video that got me to participate in the Super Bowl. 1 or 2 weeks later, that's when they said I was part of the show. As you can see, I love sneakers. I have so many sneakers, I just lose count. My most favorite would have to be my Air Force Ones.
There's still some sneakers behind there that you haven't seen. And he has the whole continuum here from the time he was 3 to the time he graduated, all the track teams, the little girlfriends, the whole 9.
They're actually not my girlfriends. These are my friends. But I did have some girlfriends back in the day. So as my mom mentioned, this is me when I was 3.
He was first determined to have a disability at age 2. I jumped on it right out of the gate. It was a long journey, but by the time he got in 11th or 12th grade, he was mastering all of his tests. If anybody is a mother and you got a child with a disability, when you see them thrive, it's like moving mountains. Every time he reaches a milestone or climbs a mountain or move a mountain, you know, it brings tears to my eyes. He showed me his dance routine. I already know he's a good dancer, but I didn't know if we could dance like that. I'm so proud of him. I always look forward to him doing great things.
Just wanted to see what I can do. I'm ready to show out. I'm doing it for my city, the Tampa Bay 813, all the way. Just making my mama proud. She's been like my biggest cheerleader since birth, and I'm still happy that she's still out by my side. I guess you could say I could sometimes be a mama's boy towards her.
Yeah, that's mama's baby. He will always be my baby.
Yeah.
This is all Super Bowl history. Every year, yeah. All these people come to volunteer. I just want to thank you guys for volunteering for the show. We know it's tough, but you guys are killing it. It's going to look amazing next Sunday. We're going to make history, and it's because of you all. And I just want to thank you again for all your time and effort, and we will see you at the next rehearsal. All right, appreciate you. A little more vertical until the last second. The wind factors are pretty important here. 1 minute, it's 10 miles an hour. Yesterday, they were almost 20.
Okay.
25 miles an hour or better, we can't fly them. We'll see what happens in rehearsal tonight.
I think this is gonna look really good. Essentially, this is what they're gonna have, like that.
It's all integrated in the lighting of the show.
Do we win for having the coolest concept?
Yes.
Yeah?
We are the Monday of Super Bowl week.
tonight we are going to be doing our first walkthrough in the stadium. Typically, the bulk of the stress and just about all the eyeballs from the NFL side is on how minimally can you impact the grass. We want as few people on the field as possible.
Hey, Aaron, good news. The field crew was able to get us one pass on the grass.
Right.
I know it's not ideal, but at least we'll have one.
I think we do two passes with the tarps on, mm-hmm. and then we do our third pass as our dress rehearsal.
There is a science behind the condition of the field at game time, and it revolves around player safety. The more you run on that field, dance on the field, you do damage to it. That's why there's no rehearsal after Thursday. So at the end of the night, all of these scientists go out and they look at the damage to the field and then they send out a report. If they feel like it was too much damage, then they'll say, okay, now you only get four runs. Two, one. And if it rains, it's really a problem. When they explained that to me, I was like, what do you mean? We can just run up and down the field all night. They're like, no. That scares the shit out of me. Because we are running out of time the minute we start rehearsals.
We can walk Abel down onto the field. We're just getting the stairs in now.
Okay. Abel, the first thing, let's try to see how this feels for you to go down, okay. go down, and walk all the way to 50.
Okay. How long is the space between when I finish that last note to when I have to sing?
Technically, it's like to House of Balloons. For you to get there, it's like 35 seconds.
And then I start singing from there, right, when I'm walking.
Exactly. Over. But you have all those ad-libs, the oh, yay. Yeah. Are you doing that as you walk down?
No, I want to get here.
Ooh, okay. Okay.
So, Abel, they're very sensitive about the grass, just so you know. Okay. And basically, if we're in good graces tonight, they're going to be great for us for the rest of the week.
It'll just be me on there.
Yeah.
It's keeping me.
KP, do we have headphones?
Show the dancers will be on E1 or E2 without my voice or guidance.
Thank you so much.
Yeah.
It's all theory right now, but you know the truth once you're in rehearsal. It's a lot of pieces that could cause huge problems. It's a big Lego set we're putting together.
Evan Cat, go ahead, hit it.
The cast has never done it full from the top to the bottom. Dance, crew, wardrobe. Abel has to walk his track. Abel has never walked the track. Every moving part has to be put together in 7 days. 7 days. And we start now.
Abel, I want to do all the blocking with you without them so that you know your path.
Okay, here we go.
He's got to at least come to the downstage edge of it. You're going to get such a scream when they actually see him.
Yeah.
Think about it. It's like, you waited 45 seconds for the video.
Yeah.
Then we open, and nobody saw him, and we're just stuck in this box.
Okay. Jesse wants to kind of see you, and then you can kind of back into it.
Jesse wants to see me, and then back into it.
Yes.
Got it.
So let's try that one. Ha, 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 ha. Do you want to do like that? Yeah.
It's so beautiful, man. Yeah, the planets
are. You don't know the elephant finale?
I mean, it's believable. I can see it.
Wait till you see the fucking elephant, dude.
There you go. There you go.
Very
Scarface.
Yeah, exactly.
This is called
no elephant.
Yes.
Do you feel like it started up?
Pull a little bit, yeah. Okay. Y'all got this perfected.
Nice little massage.
No, I feel like I'm at the spa right
yeah,
now.
Yeah, right?
Wow.
gearing up for this, I already knew. I was like, it's going to be a whole thing where we just have to wear the mask the whole time. You get used to it, though. You adjust like everybody else. Thank you so much. Appreciate y'all.
So guys, please keep the infinity room like you did yesterday.
Yeah. Yeah.
Do whatever you have to do. Just please take charge of it, yeah? Yeah, okay. So I don't have to drop no more F-bombs. Yeah? Yeah? Good luck. Bye, guys!
We on point for Charm.
We on point.
We doing this for Charm.
Our jackets are here.
They look perfect. Exactly how the picture was.
Yeah, they look good. Problem solved. Did you get your LED?
I did.
Okay, thanks. Thank you. Hi, honey. Hi. How are you? Hang this on the hook and then take the bottom and put it in the bag so it doesn't get messed up. Treat it kindly, please.
Okay, well, thank you.
Hi.
Hi.
How are you?
Good, thank you.
Guys, this part is gonna go underneath your chin. You got it? And then also this piece, just bend it so it fits onto your nose.
Look at that.
Hello, Joshua.
Hi there.
I heard you needed me.
Yeah, I think it's too small for me.
All right, so you got to take your mask off, my dear. So the easiest way when you're putting it on is to put this on before you put on your mask. Mm-hmm. Come with me, Joshua. Taking you to the place where magic happens. Yes?
Much better.
I'm saying, you get the VIP treatment for real.
Corio, can you just get them into the end zone and line them up, okay? Go and line up in the end zone, 200s.
South side, you gotta stop, they went too far.
Good.
The thing that's not solid is the self's entrance.
They just don't know when to do it yet. They're holding down the back line, like, super well. You know how it is out there when the great floor covering is on it? You can't see anything.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, KB, we're just missing some people there.
Finding this very specialized cast, it's difficult. Once we finally got the ball rolling and I started to relax a little bit, I do believe somehow it always works out. It might be by the skin of our teeth, but it really worked out this time.
Okay, so if you go next to Charm, let her know we can try this once with the track, but we're gonna have to do it right now, but we're not clean yet.
Cast, which is about representation, having people that look like us in the field. All of the boys up there were people of color. There was something about just seeing them all dance on the field, as free as they were. It was like, yeah, we're here now. This is us.
This is Hamish now just rolling through his shots, looking to see what is available to him. So there's a massive truck farm out in the parking lot. Hamish is out there. Yeah. Producers were in the pirate ship, and that's how we make it work.
So Hamish, Jesse, can you hear me?
Yeah, can you hear me, Hamish? Yep, I'm looking at it.
Yeah.
This is our transition?
Well, I mean, it's an option. Can you come? Okay, so I think fine. I think come wide then, please.
Here's a question.
Yeah.
What is in the screen as he's coming down at that moment?
Well, this is what I've been banging on about forever.
Hamish, as the director, is responsible for what the world sees. He has 18 cameras. He's calling all of those shots in the moment.
So 15, can you give me the choir boy first, please, as he comes down? And James, can you just make sure we've got all these ISOs, because I think there might be some good stuff here.
He's got to keep in mind the set. There's certain moments of choreography.
The moon is coming up.
Down by 10.
Take 4 instead, 4.
Oh, that's dope.
He's got to be thinking about all of those things, and it's a delicate dance.
Strings, please, 15. Hold your shot, 13. That's nice, 13 as well. Okay, they're down the field now, everybody. Down to the field, 13, down to the field, 4.
He's done some of the biggest things on television. He's done this show multiple times.
Where's Tiffany?
He's been at every single rehearsal with his cell phone. Coming up with his shots. He is phenomenal at helping showcase what everyone else has brought to the table so that the world can see it.
Looked terrific. That pass was great. That
yeah,
last one.
There's definitely a few messy moments that we need to really get in and amongst, but I think overall, there's some new angles definitely going to help it. We're a long way off, but I know that we've got the shots that we need. It's just they're not in the right order. You'll see. But let's watch you
want
back.
To sit in the middle?
Pyro.
Now is really that time to fine tune. We're a team of OCD people, so everyone is looking at every single detail, every single pass, and it gets better every time.
Okay. Can we pause it for a second?
Yeah.
Can we have every time it hits those stabs, can we have like a different, like a doom, different camera, doom, or like, have a feel more dramatic and energy.
Okay.
So different camera angles on those hits?
Yeah, maybe. Yeah. Yeah.
Alex had that idea too, it was good.
Yeah, yeah. That's what he told
me. Yeah.
We run it all through and then we're down for about 20 minutes and we give notes.
One thing that Abe was super adamant about was ensuring more of the stadium. He wants to feel that pandemonium with like the lights and the seats.
So it was a mess. A couple cameras didn't make it down there. They were behind you. They didn't get there in time. So don't quit.
I think they're cutting too many ultra wides, you know?
Aren't you gonna need ultra wides to get that like Chinese Olympics feeling though?
Definitely for moments, but I'm just saying like when you enter the field for House of Balloons
yeah.
and then like we're seeing them for the first time.
I think there should be something between that set and this set. Is there pyro maybe, like seeing the stadium?
What do you mean, like a wide shot and then come in?
One of my roles is noticing those really minute visual details that the viewer may not notice on the surface, but it makes a huge difference in the overall scope of it. When he turns around, you see the backs of the world.
Oh,
do you understand what and the building should be double-sided or not at all?
All right, so let's give Bruce that note.
Everybody will go home, and then it's on you to get your mind right, visualize it over and over and over until the last rehearsal.
Oh, my God, that was incredible, bro. That was incredible.
I think too much smoke at the beginning for me.
Yeah, still too much smoke, for sure.
Especially because I got the glasses now, too. I can't see shit.
Okay.
So where do you want the jets to fly?
So the jets are going to fly at the very end. So like there.
Right at the very, like,
after
the pyro.
I think the pyro's a beat late. Now, pyro. Bam.
Jets.
Jets?
Jets.
And then you want jets.
Bam, jets. Yeah.
Off it after the second hit. Yeah. Okay. Just as long as there's just, like, not finish and then the jets.
No, no way.
We know when CBS goes away at 6:15:20, those jets are going to fly over 11 minutes and 13 seconds later.
There's all sorts of things that can happen in live broadcast.
Yep.
So I'm just wondering, like, if there's a contingency or how that works.
They're going almost 300 miles an hour.
Right.
And it's only 14.8 miles from the point to here.
To here, understood.
So once they leave the hold, we can probably gain or lose about 3 seconds.
Okay, yeah. That's perfect.
Yeah, so you get
so we have minutes. A 3 second window.
And the pyro's going off before the flyover?
It is. We will still have smoke, but compared to traditional pyrotechnics you'd see in a national anthem, we'd be about 70% less smoke.
Cool.
Oh, that's perfect. Silver Lace Comet with tail coming off the north scoreboard. Jason, counting you in 3, 2, 1, fire. 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 We've already got most of the stadium cabled and our control location set up. So now it's really getting the product up to the roof and working through rehearsals to make any last minute adjustments to the cues and the timing of the cues.
Traditionally, the Thursday night rehearsal is the final rehearsal. We're always looking for any kind of a chance to improve before the actual live show.
Hey, Ez, come this way.
Very excited. I'm very emotional.
Very overwhelmed.
It's so great to see you. Lamar.
It's Lamar?
Must have got cut up.
Maybe.
All I can say is I feel just so happy to be here doing a big old show.
Yes.
You know, because I've done a few, but I haven't done a rock and roll show for a year.
Yeah.
And it's a very special feeling.
Yeah.
To just be walking around, seeing those faces, you know, it's something, it's magical. Yeah, can't wait.
Our last rehearsal, it's gotta be flawless. We are literally counting on people to have it ingrained in their head so much that they can just come back Sunday with no run through and just hit it. So that's where the anxiety and the stress really kicks in.
I know a lot of the NFL people will be looking at the on-off time, the final reset look.
We're at 6 minutes to get this thing ready for halftime show.
All right, and what about on the backside?
A little longer.
Do we want to say the number in front of Seth?
Or no, not yet.
Not yet?
I think it was at 10.
Yeah.
So
you need us to be at 6, right?
That's what I want you guys to hit. But if we're still pulling out some things off camera at 6, you know, we can live with that.
It'll be the first time the NFL sees it. It'll be the first time Pepsi sees it.
There we go, everyone. Step by.
When you think about it, it's like, okay, all these things could cause huge problems. You just don't want anything to go wrong.
2, 3, 4, 7.
One of the things about this Super Bowl that is the most exciting to me and also the most important is the opportunities that it's created. It's the opportunities behind the camera, but also the example that it's setting for people who are watching of what can be achieved. It's been an amazing feeling to look around and see people being able to showcase their talent on this world stage.
Thunder. That's like the most finished first pass I think I've ever seen.
So nice. Okay, good, good.
People don't realize that the soul behind the show is really all of these people who are making it a reality. They put blood, sweat, and tears into every little detail.
Solid.
Sorry, have fun. That last pass, I was actually having fun.
That looks like it.
Yeah.
And the pass before that, too, it looks like you're, like, just so in it. You're not...
Do I look tired in any of it?
No, not at all.
Playing sports must be way more nerve-wracking.
Than singing?
Yeah, dude.
Really?
Because singing, everybody wants to see you sing and wants to hear you, but sports, it's like, you cannot lose, bro.
Yeah. Have you realized you're doing it yet? As it felt like, it still doesn't feel like it.
Super Bowl, man.
Dude, it's so crazy, man. Sal, let me get you.
Hey, yo, Danny.
Brother.
Danny!
Bro, showtime, man.
Showtime, showtime, bro.
We gotta discuss the plans for what time we all gonna arrive.
Did y'all wanna go to church?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure we got time for that.
Yeah, we got time for that. We're all right together from there. This is really happening. You know, this is surreal, man.
You ready, Josh?
Yeah.
Show them what you got, baby.
Sure. How are you doing?
Mommy's nervous.
You can tell.
How can you tell?
The way you're speaking.
Don't act like you know me.
I do. You're my mom.
Okay, so maybe you do know me. I love you, baby. I'll talk to you later, okay?
Bye.
Bye. I see the field.
Yeah. Hello. You're good to go. They'll show you where to park.
Amazing.
Thank you.
So happy game day.
Okay, should be able to set it down on the ground. Thank you, guys.
You're welcome.
This is it.
Hi, hey, how you doing, buddy?
They're going to check your watermarks.
Can you see by the dawn's early light?
I feel really good.
How's Lamar and Abel and all that camp at
Elgin? I hear he's very relaxed. I talked to Matt earlier. He said he's just completely zoned in and, you know, ready to go.
Hi, everybody. They will take your temperature as you enter the door.
Kind of nervous.
See that sticker? So you're good to go. There's a new section row and seat number for you.
Thank you.
How are you?
Okay.
See your name tags. We got Joshua Felder. All
right. Well, yeah, this is it right here. As soon as we put this on, man, that's how we know it's real.
Oh, that's perfect right there, right?
Yeah.
There's a column. Don't forget the column.
Oh, yeah, my bad.
Okay. They're holding this. Oh,
hold
this. Oh,
yeah.
Y'all gotta get the shoes, man. Y'all gotta get the shoes.
Y'all gotta get the shoes.
Oh.
It's gonna be epic.
We ready.
Y'all ready?
I'm nervous.
Oh, hey. Oh,
it's time for football, and here we go. Super Bowl 55 is underway.
Part of the excitement is the nervousness. Is what you planned, what you hoped, what you dreamed of, is it going to happen? This show will not be successful because of me. It'll be successful because of the close to 1,000 people that touched this process in some way, shape, or form, starting with the Weeknd on down. It does take the entire village.
All right. There we go, brother. There we go.
Let's fucking go.
Hamish, we're clear to start. Have they brought Abel up yet?
Soak in that moment. Nice and calm.
Stand by.
Have a great, 10, great show, everybody.
Nine,
it's really good.
Eight, seven, one. Six, five, four, three, two.
The National Football League welcomes you to the Pepsi Super Bowl 55 halftime show.
Terrifying before the show started. Being at the pinnacle of success, the Super Bowl, being at the biggest stage in the world. It was just straight anxiety. Then, you know, when he hit the stage, there was silence. The only thing I could hear was just him singing. For like 13 minutes straight, going through those hits. Very, very, very surreal moment. Just looking back at how Abel and I met, and where we came from, how we got to that point. Coming from where we're from, we're not supposed to be here. We're not supposed to be given that opportunity. A lot of my peers didn't make it out. It's just crazy to think that we did all of this in under 10 years. I'm just forever grateful to be a part of the process and be here.
The National Football League thanks you for watching the Pepsi Super Bowl 55 halftime show.
Thank you, everybody. That was amazing. Perfect. Congratulations to everybody. Thank you again.
Told you, everyone.
Killed it.
You killed it.
Award show was flawless.
Congratulations to you. Thank you.
Oh, my God.
Congratulations. It feels so emotional right now.
Your dancers did it. I feel like I can finally fucking breathe.
I've been running up.
Holy shit. Where's Abel at?
Don't stop.